And that matchup right there you see in the center circle will be one to watch. Well, Brittany Griner and anyone is one to watch, but against the rookie, Dorca Juhas. The rookie, Juhas.
In their last meeting, Minnesota did a great job of turning over Phoenix and forcing them into quite a few turnovers. They had 22 in that game.
Onyemata gets the scoring going for Phoenix.
A different game than she had in the last game where she struggled to find her offense, struggled to find her defense, like a typical rookie has those games.
Griner with the hook shot.
She wants to learn how to do that, and I loved it, and I would love to see her figure out how to get a good hook shot.
Miller with the three-pointer, and that's already more points than she had in the last game.
Mariah Jefferson, a good fit on this Phoenix team.
Collier with that step back move. She's gotten so good. It's an effective one, and she scores in the paint.
Turnovers again, a problem for Phoenix.
Juhas, the 3-point try. Good. Dorca Juhas hits the long shot.
Play you straight up.
Off the Onyemata miss. Here's McBride in traffic. All alone, it's Miller. Offensive rebound and put back. That's the fourth turnover by Phoenix already in the first quarter. The Lynx had a season high in steals in Phoenix. Lindsay Allen makes it hurt. 2 for 2, but have since gone 0 for 7. Collier off the dribble, pulls up and hits it over Griner. All but 2 of Minnesota's points have come from that front court. Shea Petty in the game for Phoenix picks up the dribble, finds Cunningham. The 3-pointer's good, and a foul against Diamond Miller. Just a common foul. 3 and 1. Cunningham didn't hit it though. Bridget Carlton, the zip pass to Collier.
Everyone knows where they're supposed to be. Great communication by Carlton and Collier.
Shug Sutton gets it out to Jefferson, and Mariah Jefferson hits a 3. Tough start for the Mercury. They come into this game 3-13. Good drive by McBride. Milic the rebound, and Collier gets it ahead to Allen. Lindsay Allen hangs in the air off the glass.
They're struggling here with 10 points in this one.
Rachel Banham gets herself free. Good job by Milic to come up with that offensive rebound. Gets the putback and 1. 2 made baskets in the final 9 minutes of the first quarter. Emily Engsler and Kayana Traylor both in for Minnesota. The hardship contracts signed in the last couple of weeks. And Bridget Carlton.
Yeah, getting situated and settled in. And her and Griner have a nice, she gives some space for Griner when she's hitting her 3-point shots.
Milic going right at Griner and getting the basket. Lynx started this season 0-6, but have since gone 8-3. And Banham rolls one in for her first basket of the game. Onyemata off the screen from Griner. Sutton, the lob now to Griner, turns around, lays it in. Brittany Griner was not about to let Lindsay Allen get a third layup in this half. Onyemata, a nice move in the reverse layup.
Minnesota will live with those shots from Griner. She's going to shoot from out there. No doubt.
Juhas into Collier. The high-low game for Minnesota results. Juhas sets the screen, rolls to the basket. Allen just keeps it because she got free. Loose ball comes up to Allen. Minnesota's got it again. McBuckets finishes that possession with the 3-pointer. McBride with 7 first-half points. Minnesota is really well-balanced offensively tonight. Petty from the baseline right in front of her bench drains a 3 for the answer. That's her 7th board of the game.
The Lynx come out in the second half with strong defense, which leads to good offense right there with a nice lay-in by Napheesa Collier.
Miller, you just see how wide her eyes get when she is bringing the ball up in a transition. Collier hits the turnaround. Napheesa Collier now at 12 points. That they are. Turner gets around Collier that time. Onyemata gets one to bounce in. Michaela Onyemata. Allen, who tried to get it to Collier, a rare turnover for Lindsay Allen, who had set a record for consecutive assists without a turnover. A foul on Diamond Miller as Michaela Onyemata. And so did Onyemata just there. So the Lynx catch a little bit of a break. And Lindsay Allen gets the roll. She's fouled.
Carlton to Allen. Back to Bridget Carlton. Deep three-pointer. BC for three. Really good. Turner tracks down the rebound. Onyenwede. Oh, McBride met her at the rim. Onyenwede got the basket on the hard foul. But neither of them would go down. Griner holds the ball high. McBride reaches in, tries to knock it away. Brittany Griner. Beautiful move by Brittany Griner. Up and over four defenders at one point or another.
Yeah, and if I was Phoenix, I'd be going to that each and every time.
McBride hit a basket and went to the ground after the make. You know, it's a difficult position for teams in the WNBA and in the NBA for that matter. Brittany Griner, offensive rebound and put back. And BG is starting to come to life here tonight. Second half. Out for rest tonight. Taurasi on Wednesday at New York had 23 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists. Gustafson hits the two. Trying to get the pass away. It's stolen by Onyenwede. All the way in. Rolls off. Second chance is good. Onyenwede worked hard for that basket. She's got 16 points. Onyenwede. Gustafson off the glass and in. Megan Gustafson with the putback basket. Mercury trying to pick up a fourth win this season.
Minnesota doing a good job of protecting the paint.
Ooh, Onyenwede with a three over the outstretched arm of Rachel Bannum. Engsler feeds Miller, Diamond Miller. Soft touch up and over the defense. Napheesa Collier will be representing the Lynx, and that player right there, Brittany Griner, will represent the Mercury after that putback basket. Griner now with 10 points.
Yeah, Griner having to work.
It was 18-10. Minnesota's led by double digits since then. And Rachel Bannum puts it right back to a double-digit game.
Yeah, nice looking.
Get it to Griner. Allen, the fake on the pass, gets her free for the shot. Gets it into Milic. Nina Milic turns into the defense. It goes off the glass. Here's Brianna Turner. Milic met her in the lane. Turner gets Cunningham on the backdoor cut.
Wow, how did she thread the needle?
Against the Lynx. 22 turnovers. We've talked about it. Minnesota had 13 steals, a season high for the Lynx. Milic, that basket will count. Griner, long two, and she's got that kind of range in her game. It's probably a win for the Lynx. We'll see if they can do that and get it home. Knocked away on the entry pass. Right back into the hands of Shook Sutton, and that was a big turn of events. Onyenwede. A nice driving basket. She's got a season high now with 21 points.
The one player on this team who is effective on the offensive end of the floor.
Carlton lines up and hits it. Another BC three. Grew up in Port Wing, Wisconsin, near Duluth. About a three-hour drive here from the Twin Cities and has 30-plus friends and family in the stands today. Hey, Kayana Trailer. Congratulations to Kayana.
Yeah, that has to feel good.
And it was a swish, too, a beauty. Gustafson, the turnaround. Going on top of what is going to be another win for the Lynx. Onyenwede got one. That's a three-pointer. Changing the margin just a little bit. Going on top of what is going to be another win for the Lynx. Onyenwede got one. That's a three-pointer. Changing the margin just a little bit.